A pleasant and joyous good morning from Natasha ma'am to all of you. So children, welcome to the social science class of day 2, where we are going to study about the regional kingdoms of 7th to 12th century. But before that, let's have a recap of what we had done last week. So we did the major kingdoms and empires that came up in the 7th and 12th century and the difference between the kingdoms and the empires. Then the entire period is studied into two distinct periods. Then after the death of Harshvardhana, his empire broke up and many new kingdoms appeared. Then who were the Samantas and what role did they play during this time? Then why was Hiranyagarbha so important for kings? That was to change them into Kshatriyas. When and how did the Pala dynasty came into existence? So today we are going to continue our session with the administration in the kingdoms. Now here children, you can see the coins and inscriptions. So during the Chola kings, over 400 different kinds of taxes were collected from the people during the Chola kings. And we will study about how the various kingdoms were administered by the kings, Samantas and village landlords. Here, as you can see, these are the resources from which we can understand the administration in the kingdoms. Now, kings gave grand titles to glorify themselves. What is glorify? To show themselves that we are very smart and we are very great. So to glorify themselves, they gave them titles. What were the titles? Maharaja Adhiraja. And what was the meaning of it? Overlord of the kings. Overlord means the head of the kings. Then Tribhuvan and Chakravartin. What were Tribhuvan and Chakravartin? Lords of the three worlds. So they wanted to glorify themselves. But despite of these titles and prestige, the king could not rule all by himself because he always needed the support of his Samantas and various associates. So among the Samantas, many people helped them and even the peasants. People from influential families and the close relatives of the kings held key positions in the army. That means the dynasties were there and the people from influential families were only kept in the army at a higher position. Now, how was the revenue collected? And why was it collected? Why did the kings collect the taxes? Taxes means revenue. So the kings collected taxes for the land grants. What is the land grants? That means that they used to grant land and then in lieu of that they used to give money. Then finance their establishments. Establishments means whatever they used to take, they used to establish them and they used to give money instead of that. The king often gave grants of tax-free lands to Brahmins. Then to wage wars. Means for wars they needed arms, ammunition, all those things. That is why they collected the taxes and they said we are going to spend on these things. Then they constructed massive structures. The kings often gave grants of tax-free lands to Brahmins. For what? The Brahmins were given tax because of one reason, that is to construct massive structures like temples, forts and palaces. So this was whole the aim behind the kings collecting the taxes. Now we come to the Prashastis. Prashastis, as we did last year also, were the Sanskrit poems written by Brahmins in praise of the kings. And Kalhana. What was Kalhana? He was a person, he composed these Prashastis on the history of the kings of Kashmir. Then he was known for his Ratnagirini or the River of Kings. ही यूज्ड अ वैरायटी ऑफ हिस्टोरिकल सोर्सेज लाइक इंस्क्रिप्शंस, दीज आर इंस्क्रिप्शंस, दीज देन द डॉक्यूमेंट्स देन अर्लियर हिस्ट्रीज विच वर रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑन दीज वॉल्स एज इंस्क्रिप्शंस देन द कॉइन्स एट दैट टाइम. नाउ अनदर कॉन्फ्लिक्ट बिटवीन किंगडम्स केम अप. All of them targeted Kanauj. This was Kanauj on the map, and all of them, they here Chamannas are also there, Chandelas are also there, Palas also there, but they targeted Kanauj because it was a very rich dynasty. So now the Gujara Pratiharas, the Pala, and the Rashtrakuta, these three of the them the kingdoms, they went towards Kanauj and they conflicted between one another just to take over Kanauj. Why? Because since three parties were involved, that is Gujara Pratihara, Pala and Rashtrakuta, that is why in the 8th century it was known as the tripartite struggle by the historians, because three of these kings, they went in conflict with one another for Kanauj. Now we come to the conflicts of wealth of temples. Now there was a ruler, Sultan Mahmud, a Turkey ruler of Ghazni in 1997 CE to 1030 CE, and in the Indian subcontinent he was the richest person. But to add to his riches, he went and he targeted great riches stored in temples and cities of India, and he ruled over the parts of Central Asia, Iraq, parts of the subcontinent. He carried out 17 attacks on temples, out of which Somnath temple, here you can see Somnath temple, and here is Mahmud, Sultan Mahmud. So he carried out 17 attacks, out of which Somnath temple in Gujarat was the most terrifying. Then assigned a task of writing an account of the subcontinent to a Persian scholar. He was very attracted towards the people of India, so he asked a Persian scholar, Al-Biruni, which later became important source of Indian history. He wanted them to write about his history. Now, what are the things that we learned today? Please pay attention on this: administration in kingdoms and how were it carried out by the kings, then revenue and tax system during the Chola kings, about the Prashtis and the Tripathi struggle, which was the three kingdoms coming together, then conflicts for wealth where the main target were the temples of India like the Somnath temple. So conflicts for craving on empire, where after the death of Mahmud, and it was taken over by Sultan Muhammad, who fought with all his might and killed Prithviraja III. So we'll continue our chapter in the third session also. So children, please do your worksheets. Everything is given in the video. Go through the video again and again, and you'll understand the chapter itself. So please pay attention, go through the video again and again, and tune in with me again in the third session. Have a nice day and take care of yourself. God bless you all.